guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So, if you follow me on Instagram, you do know that I do get laser done. So every time I say laser, people are often confused of what laser I'm talking about. So I'm getting my laser hair removal done from a clinic called Skin Lab by Jamuna Pai, which is in Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad. I believe they have clinics across India. So you can, you know, if you want to check it out, you can check it out from other countries, not countries, but states as well. But I live in Hyderabad, so I'm going for the Jubilee Hills branch in Hyderabad. So, I just also one more thing realized that I'm wearing a white blazer, which makes me look like a doctor, which was not the intention. I was just like, you know, wearing something underneath, and I already filmed a video. I was like, let me just put on something, and I put a white blazer on, but I realized that I do look like a doctor now, which is not the intention. I'm not here to give professional help. I'm just going to answer and help you guys with my personal experience and what I know about laser. But I would definitely make a very good looking doctor, like, I mean, look at it. Anyways, so I asked you guys on Instagram about like all the various queries, because you had a lot of questions about it. So I took down all the questions you guys asked, and I'm going to answer them according to my experience and what I know about laser. So let's get started. So let's start off with what exactly is laser hair removal and how does it work. So laser is designed to go and kill and burn the black cell in our skin. So usually, because hair is, you know, black follicle, when you shoot the laser, it just goes and burns the black hair or the follicle of your hair, and hence, like, you know, repeated burning of the hair and shooting. This is basically how my dermatologist explained it, and I'm explaining to you. I'm sure, you know, there are mistakes here and there, but when you shoot the laser, it targets the black follicle and it basically burns the hair follicle, reducing the hair and the hair growth. So it's way easier to do laser on lighter skin tones, because, you know, there's a lot of difference between the hair follicle color and your skin color. So especially if you are really fair or like medium to fair and you have really thick hair, and then it's very easy for the laser to go and just burn the hair. But if you are like a little more deeper skin tone or darker skin tone, they kind of reduce the frequency. I don't know what is the, you know, units which is used in the laser. You just like assume there is a number I'm using. I'm calling it a frequency. So according to your complexion, according to your skin texture, your hair texture, they adjust it accordingly. So I personally had amazing experience with Skin Lab. I have actually no complaints. The doctor does the laser. It's not like, you know, just a random staff is doing it, like how it is in most of the clinics. Here the dermatologist is right there, and they only do the laser, only the shaving part, etc. The other workers do, and they are so sweet. I can't even tell you. Literally every 5 minutes, are you okay, madam? Are you comfortable, madam? It's like, don't be so sweet with me. It's too, you know, I'm like, I'm fine. So I personally had an amazing experience with them. It's a very super luxurious clinic. It's very, very hygienic, especially because C is going on. I don't want to use the complete word. We have to be very, very cautious, and they are extremely hygienic and extremely clean. Procedure usually is like, once I go, they shave my hands and legs, then they add like a gel, a cooling gel across like the area where they, wherever they want to like do the laser, and then they just take the machine and shoot it. For me personally, you know, I really have extremely thick hair, and I'll leave you very, very thick hair. Like, if there's the thickest amount of hair anybody can have, I think I have it for my legs especially. So I've done 4 sessions for my legs and 2 sessions for my hand, because I started my hands a little later. So for my legs also, like, they use different frequencies for different parts. Like for my knees, I have a lot thicker hair and very coarse hair, so they, you know, use a little different stronger frequency there, but the rest of the legs it's fine. So, you know, they balance it out and do it, because the doctor is there. There's nothing to worry about, because they know what they're doing. So they're just like, you know, do the laser all across the area wherever you want to do it, and they clean it, moisturize it, and they send you home. They just ask you to not, like, you know, put hot water or like soap or anything for the next 24 hours, and after that it's good to go. Sometimes you get a little red, but it's very temporary, because, you know, obviously you shave and then do it, but there's no like long-term effects or anything for that, and that's it, you'll be done. And again, when it completely grows back, you can go for like the next session and you'll be good to go. So as the number of sessions keep increasing, the period also keeps increasing. Like initially the first 2 months or 3 months I went like every 1 month, but now like since the third session and fourth session I had like a huge gap. I gave it like 2.5 months because my hair did not completely grow out, and if it did not grow out then there won't be anything for the laser to go and hit, right? So the doctor said come when it completely grows out, then that time we can properly actually do it and it will be more effective. One thing I cannot exactly answer is the cost, because I'm getting it done for free. They offered me their services and I agreed to take them. So I can give you approximate cost, but I'm not really sure. So it's better if you DM them or go visit them or call them. But when I did find out, they said it's like around 60 to 70,000 for 6 sessions of your legs. But it again depends. So it's better you call them and find it out. So the first question and the most common question is how many sessions of laser is required. So a minimum of 6 sessions is always recommended. So I'm personally at 4, but I have really, really thick hair. So I might need to do 1 or 2 more sessions to get it like to minimal as possible. But if you have really less hair, maybe like 5 or 6 would be more than enough. But at least 6 is always recommended. The next question is a continuation question, is how many times should we visit for a complete treatment? So like I told you, it really depends on the hair growth. So initially the first 2 or 3 months, if the hair is growing back very quicker, you might have to come back every 4 to 6 weeks. That's what the doctor even recommends, that come back after 4 to 6 weeks. But if your growth is very, very less and you're not even seeing anything, you can go a little longer and go after 2 months as well. So let's say every 6 weeks, that would make almost 9 months, I think, if I'm not wrong. Yeah. So next question, is it okay to do laser on your face? Yes, laser on face is completely fine. It's actually a lot better, though it's expensive. It's more long term and a lot better than other methods, because waxing can make your skin saggy. Threading is so damn painful. Laser is not cheap, and of course, I'm in no way saying like laser hair removal or hair removal is a mandate. It's of course a personal choice always, but if you do want to get it, then this is what will help you. No way, shape or form, don't remove your hair if you don't want to. If you are very comfortable with it, kudos to you, so proud of you. So the next question is, I've got laser done for my upper lip about 4 years back and the entire part just got dark. Is it common with laser? So like I told you, it is very, very important for a professional to do your laser, because only a doctor knows what to do. If even something goes wrong, the doctor will always know what to do. So don't get it done with any random place where any random people are doing it. Make sure there's a doctor who always is there to check on you. You adjust the frequency according to your skin type. Probably you did have somebody who was inexperienced or and didn't know what to do for your skin. So be a little careful, go to a proper place and you would not have that experience. So the next question is, does it cause any burning sensation? It's not a burning sensation, it's like a prick, but if you can tolerate waxing and threading laser, it's literally lalu. It doesn't pain as much. It's just that whenever that laser goes and hits the hair follicle, you just feel a little prick. It's literally little to none. You don't feel it as much as waxing or threading, and it does not burn. You don't feel like it's burning or something. It does not hurt in any way. Next question is, can we go for a full body laser? Of course you can go for a full body laser. They do literally each and every part. You can get your bikini done, chest done, face done, hands done, underarms done, full legs done, everything. You can do any laser or any part on any place. Yeah. So the next question is, I still have growth, so I just use the Miniso razor to take it off. Is it normal and expected to get dark? So again, like I told you, razor hair removal is hair reduction and not permanent removal. So hair, might grow back itty bitty tiny there, but it's never as much as how you started it before, pre-laser stage. Now still I do have hair which grows back and I shave it off. It's completely fine. You're not supposed to remove it from the root, because next time you go for a session, the follicle has to be there for the laser to be working. So you can only shave while you are on a laser. So little to none hair can always be shaved, and the hair will always remain what it is. It's not going to get darker or thicker. It's just going to be as is how it is at that point, and you can completely shave and it's fine. I also shave every session. Like if I'm giving 2 months gap and I do have hair growing back and I do film videos and I don't like my hair being there, so I do shave it. It's not a big deal. The only thing they recommend doing by laser is shave. So the next question is it in any way harmful? No, laser hair removal I think is the safest thing to do. It has not shown any side effects to anybody. Like the minor side effects would be like, you know, redness or irritation for some time after you do the laser. But again, it depends on where you're getting it done. So a lot of people are complaining about their mustache getting darker after their laser. That's because, you know, the doctor might not have used the proper frequency, or they did not ice you well. Like the post-inflammation hyperpigmentation is always there, so you need to be careful about what type of laser you're going for as well. So it's always you know, good to talk to the doctor and like see what is best for your skin. So the next question is, I have PCOD, will the hair grow back even after laser? So when you have hormones imbalance, it's better first you get them under control. So while I was laser, like when I was doing back in like 5-6 years ago, I was under medication while I was on laser. So it is very important, because even if you're removing the hair, the laser is helping it, but if your hormones are not good, it's going to get more thicker and darker, and no matter what you do, it's not going to go away. So it's better first you go under some treatment for your hormones, get that under control, and then you go for laser, and that time it would actually help you a lot more. The next question is laser painful? Like I told you, if you can bear waxing and threading, then literally this is nothing. It's like prick in your skin. It does hurt a little bit, but it's very, very tolerable. So the next question is, does it lighten the skin in case we have darkness? Now you should remember, laser hair removal is just to remove hair. There are other treatments which help remove your pigmentation, etc., but laser hair removal only concentrates on your hair. So like I told you, I have the thickest hair, and my hair does grow back now, and it is still there. It's been like 4 sessions, but I'm so impressed with how far it has come. So it does grow back, but it's not as thick as it was before, and it doesn't grow back as quicker as it was before. Like previously, if I shave, it used to come back in 1, maximum 2 days. Like I shaved yesterday, today it's like I get that, you know, rough thing going on there. My, like, you know how our dads have like that thick hair, but now the hair doesn't grow back until like 15 to 20 days easily. But I'm still on 4th, so there are a lot more sessions for me to go, and I'm very sure like it'll be like the minimum as possible. So yes, it is quite effective on thick hair. In fact, it's more effective on thick hair, like I told you, because it's easier for the laser to go and hit it. So the next question, it's kind of a common question, but I do want to answer it. Do the hair come back? Does the hair come back after certain time, or is it forever goodbye? So laser hair removal is hair reduction, so it will kill your hair as much as possible, but of course you will need maintenance sessions. So sometimes for people who have like very, very less growth, and it might be like once in 1 year you might want to do a maintenance session, or for somebody who has little more, once in 6 months you can do a maintenance session, or after that if you're really, really minimal, you can just shave it off also, because it's little to nothing, and it's completely fine. If you have very less hair to begin with, then maybe it would be like it's completely gone, but they don't promise that, but that's the goal to get there. So yeah guys, those were the most common questions related to laser which I could answer. Do let me know if you have more questions, leave it in the comments. I can surely ask the doctor if you want and get back to you later in some other future video if you want. But that's it for this video. I really hope I answered most of your questions, and if you find this video useful, and if you do like what I do here, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I'll also leave the, you know, details of the clinic in the description box if you want to check it out. And yeah, that's it for this video. If you like my video, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.